My name is Jose Gomez-Marquez, and I use toys to make affordable medical devices.
So where are we?
You're at the Little Devices Lab at MIT. We're part of the Innovations and International Health Group.
I didn't expect to see these when I came to this lab. But why is this important?
So these are toys. I actually played with these when I was a little kid. But toys have a great supply chain. You can find these things pretty much anywhere in the world, even if they're knockoffs. We may take out a helicopter and harvest the rack and pinion mechanism from it. We can take an interactive plush toy that will have an alarm and make an IV sounding buzzer so that a nurse can come back and check on patients not every 5 minutes, but only when that IV is actually becoming empty. I don't think I can go buy a toy store unless I'm in a real rush and not go in. These are amazing. It's little LEDs for your fingers. I'm not sure exactly what to do with this, but I think we can find an interesting app. I'll go into a toy store and I'll start to look at the subcomponents of toys. Or we're always looking at the coupling points. How do things connect? What are the easy mechanisms that I can harvest? When you look at a toy today, you're actually looking at an engineered part. It's not the cheap injection molded plastic of 20 years ago. There are mechanical bits and pieces, there are electronic bits and pieces. Sometimes there's even chemistry that you can harvest from the toys. What are these?
It's called Nanoglux, and it's kind of like Silly Putty. It changes color.
No way. Really? You may not have the courage to hack a $1,000 device, but you definitely have the courage to hack something that's $5. And then if you add a little bit of ingenuity, it becomes something as powerful as a $1,000 medical device. We invent every day at the Little Devices Group at MIT. That's where we focus on the DIY experimentation for medical devices. And that's where the medikits came out of. We have right now 5 different medikits. A medikit is essentially a collection of Lego-like construction blocks. But instead of coming up with a car or a house or a doll, you come up with a medical device. So it's erector sets for medical technologies.
So this is what one of the kits would look like.
This is for microfluidics. We said, why don't we use Legos as a way of using a scientific breadboard, basically, to make our own chips. And so each one of these components locks onto a Lego piece, and inside is a single feature of a microfluidic circuit. You put each feature together however you would, based on what you need.
People who need to test blood for all sorts of different things.
Yeah.
This is what a crucial ingredient is to that.
Exactly.
So if you have this sort of kit, you can offer blood testing all over the world, in places where they typically couldn't do it.
Right.
Cholesterol, heart disease, diabetes, the biggest killers, really.
It's a little renegade, but we've learned that if you don't make somebody uncomfortable in what you're doing, it's probably not that innovative to begin with.